Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to film today's video because I love filming these. I'm going to be sharing some good drugstore dupes and also some really affordable alternatives that actually perform better than a lot of my favorite high-end products. Whenever I discover a drugstore dupe or just something that's very, very similar, I always write it down in a note on my phone. And then whenever I have like 9 or 10 products, I sit down to film the video. So I can't wait to jump into it and chat about these products, especially because a lot of the drugstore products are even better than the high-end alternative and a lot more affordable. I do want to say thank you to HelloFresh for sponsoring today's video. HelloFresh is the best meal kit. It is so good. My husband and I have been getting it for over 3 years, and it's something that just takes the stress out of meal planning, meal prepping, and cooking. Cooking is something that always stresses me out for some reason, and I think it's because I never really knew how to do it well, but HelloFresh breaks it down and makes it so easy. It's just convenient because whenever we're done working, we can just grab whatever meal we want to have that night, and everything is ready to go within 30 minutes. Sometimes sooner if it is one of their quick and easy options. It just takes the guesswork out of what we're going to eat. So it's actually encouraged us to cook at home more often rather than ordering takeout. And honestly, it tastes better too. I'm actually a really picky eater, so I tend to eat the same things over and over. So HelloFresh has been really good for me because they do offer so many different recipes each week, which helps me to break out of my rut and try different things. We personally do the vegetarian option, but they also have a low-cal option, Carb Smart, and pescatarian options along with their regular recipes. And like I said, the recipes taste so good. The produce actually gets to you really fast, so it's always fresh. And I like that the ingredients are already pre-portioned, so not only do we end up wasting less food, but it just makes it very simple as to what you actually have to cook. I love that the packaging they use to ship your food is almost entirely made from recyclable or already recycled content. And it's just convenient because you can always change your delivery dates or food preferences, and you can even skip a week whenever you need to. I loved reading that HelloFresh is making an effort to help those in need. In 2020, they donated over 4 million meals to charity, and they've continued to step up their food donations during COVID. You can go to HelloFresh.com and use my code 12AndreaM to get 12 free meals, including free shipping. If you've been thinking about trying HelloFresh, you will not regret it. So again, go to HelloFresh.com and use my code 12AndreaM to get 12 free meals, including free shipping. Thanks again to HelloFresh for sponsoring today's video. Let's jump into the rest of it, and I'll share some good drugstore dupes and alternatives with you. Let me start with my favorite dupe. This one is such a great deal in terms of value. So for years, I really enjoyed the Grande Cosmetics Lash Enhancing Serum, and they have one for brows and one for eyelashes. I really liked the one for my eyelashes. I felt like it made such a difference to grow out my natural lashes after I wore false lashes for years. So I definitely think that product works, but it's pretty expensive. It's $65 for 0.067 ounces. They say that it is a 3-month supply, and I would agree with that, but the problem with that type of product is you can't just use it and be done with it. You have to repurchase it and use it consistently. Now, the problem for me is I actually must have discovered or develop some sort of allergy to one of the ingredients because I used that product and it burned my eyes and my eyelashes actually started falling out. So I don't know if they changed it or all of a sudden it just didn't agree with me, but I actually switched and tried a new one from e.l.f. The e.l.f. serum can be used on your eyelashes or your brows. I haven't used it on my brows, so I can't say whether or not it works for the brows, but I love the fact that it works for my eyelashes. It's a lot more gentle than the Grande Cosmetics formula. I didn't have any issues with it, no sensitivities at all, and my natural lashes have grown so much. Now this one actually retails for $8, but it comes with twice the product. So it's crazy. It is 6 times less expensive than Grande Cosmetics and comes with twice the amount. So that is without a doubt my number one favorite dupe. I definitely recommend checking it out. You can find it at Target or on e.l.f.'s website as well. They also have a mini version at Target if you don't need the entire full-size version as well. I do have a face primer dupe and a face primer alternative that I want to share with you. So the dupe is for the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip Primer. I know a lot of people like this product. It does lock your makeup into place really well. It has a slight tacky texture to it, so when you apply your foundation, it's really going to grip onto it and it stays in place well, especially for more of a moisturizing formula. So this one is a nice option. You also get a ton of product in here. This one retails for $32 and you get 1.52 ounces. But if you're looking for a more affordable alternative that actually feels a little bit better on the skin and performs a little bit better in my opinion, then I do recommend trying the e.l.f. Mint Melt Cooling Face Primer. Now this one is only $8. It does come with less product. It comes with 1 fluid ounce, but when you break the products down price per ounce, it's actually still a better deal in terms terms of value. The Milk makeup is $21.30 per ounce and e.l.f. is $8 per ounce. So I just wanted to mention that because the Milk makeup product looks like it comes with a ton of product and it does come with more, but in terms of value, the e.l.f. is still a really great deal and definitely a better option. And this one again has a very similar feel. It has a slight sticky or tacky feel to it. So it does lock your foundation into place. But the reason why I like this one a little bit better is because it actually has like a very gentle cooling effect. I do have very sensitive skin, so this feels very soothing on my skin. It's really gentle, and I do think it has a little bit more of a moisturizing feel to it. So overall, I would reach for this one over Milk makeup anyway. So I definitely wanted to recommend it in case you guys didn't try this out. It's definitely a great alternative, and in my mind, it's pretty much a dupe, but I think I like it a little bit better. Now, I did want to share a primer alternative with you guys. It is definitely not an exact dupe, but it is a really good affordable alternative, and it might be more ideal for you if you don't have extremely oily skin. Now, you guys might know that I love the Farsali Liquid Powder Serum. I talk about this all the time on my channel. It is the most mattifying primer that I've ever tried, so it is my go-to during the spring and the summer and even heading into fall. But sometimes I feel like you don't want such an extreme mattifying base, and if you have combo skin, you're probably going want to avoid it because it mattifies your skin so intensely. I tried the Makeup Revolution Liquid Powder Pore Blurring Makeup Serum, which kind of looks like it was meant to be an exact dupe for Farsali, just based on the packaging and the claims. And it's not identical, but it's close. And the reason why I like this one is because it does give your skin a very smooth, blurred appearance, and it gives you more of a soft matte finish without being as intense as the Farsali product. So this one will lightly mattify your skin and make your skin look and feel very smooth, so foundation applies beautifully. So if you have slightly oily skin or you have combo skin and you don't need something quite as intense as Farsali, try this one from Makeup Revolution. It's also a lot less expensive. The Farsali product is $54 for an ounce. The Makeup Revolution is $12 for an ounce. So it's actually four times less expensive than Farsali for the same amount of product. And like I said, the formulas are a little bit different, but this one might be a really good alternative. So this is something that I've mentioned on my channel here and there, but I don't know that I've ever featured it in like an actual dupes video, and it is such a good dupe or alternative that I feel like I have to mention it again. So Hourglass has very, very beautiful powders. They have this one, which is the Veil Translucent Setting Powder. They also have pressed powders. My go-to is their Ambient Lighting Powder in the shade Diffused Light, but I think maybe near the end of last year, I discovered this product from e.l.f., and it is such a good alternative. In my mind, it performs just as good, and I actually think it's a little bit better. This is the e.l.f. Halo Glow Setting Powder. There are a few reasons why I like this product better. First of all, the e.l.f. Halo Glow Setting Powder actually comes in six shades. I use the shade Light, which is the lightest, so if you have a deeper skin tone than I do, I definitely recommend checking out the other shades. The Hourglass Powder, the loose powder, only comes in one shade. It is a translucent shade, but sometimes it's nice to have a little bit of a tint to your powder. Now, the pressed powders do come in a variety of shades, but they're all very, very light. The majority of them are like brightening powders or highlight powders. So depending on what you're looking for, you might want a darker shade, which I love the fact that e.l.f. does have a more extensive shade range in their powder. The e.l.f. powder is the same texture as the loose powder from Hourglass. So if you use the Hourglass powder as a finishing powder or a setting powder, then definitely try the Halo Glow and see if it compares. I actually think the textures are so similar. I wouldn't notice a difference except for the fact that the e.l.f. has a little bit of a tint to it. I would also say if you use their pressed powder ambient lighting powders, these again might be a good alternative for you. This has actually replaced the Hourglass ambient lighting powder in the shade Diffused Light because the colors are identical, and I was using Diffused Light to brighten up under my under eyes or kind of like blur out my bronzer or blush if I applied too much, and that's why I use this product. Now, obviously, a pressed powder versus a loose powder is a lot different, but I actually prefer this because it's a lot softer and it kind of looks like a second skin. It gives you like this natural glow even though there's no shimmer in here. In terms of value, the Hourglass loose powder is $46. You get slightly more product. You get 0.36 ounces, but obviously it's a lot more expensive. e.l.f. is $8 and you get 0.24 ounces. I've said this so many times, but if the e.l.f. powder was actually in Hourglass packaging, I wouldn't question it. I would think that it was a high-end luxurious product because it's that good. It's definitely one of e.l.f.'s best products. So I've been raving about the Urban Decay Brow Blade for as long as I can remember. It is my go-to brow product. First of all, I like the fact that it is a dual-ended product, so you get a pencil on one side and then an ink stain side on the other. So obviously it's great if you're traveling. I haven't brought it with me to travel recently, but I did love it for that purpose. But I just like it because it's convenient. That being said, there are so many good drugstore brow pencils out there that I feel like I could reach for any one of those. I recently discovered a few brow pens from two drugstore brands that perform just as great as the brow blade. So if you've been wanting to try out the brow blade, but you're pretty happy with your drugstore pencil, then maybe pick up one of these to complement it. So the Milani Weekend Brow is my first choice. This one comes in three different shades. It retails for $8.99, and this one works extremely well just to draw on those hair-like strokes. It stays in place well. The only downside to this one is that it does come in three shades, so it's not quite as extensive as the brow blade or the next one I'm going to mention. The brow blade comes in nine shades, but this one from NYX actually comes in one more. There are 10 shades of the NYX Lift and Snatch Brow Tint Pen. So I wear the shade Espresso in the NYX pen and also in the Milani pen, and then in the Urban Decay pen, I wear Dark Drapes, just for reference. The NYX Lift and Snatch is $11, but the nice part about NYX is that you can typically get their products on sale, like buy one, get one half off on Ulta's website. I honestly use all three of the products interchangeably. I can't really say that one is a lot better than the other because I do find that they all perform so similarly. They all stay in place extremely well. They're all very, very pigmented. I would say maybe the Milani brow pen is a little bit more subtle compared to the other two. So if you do like more of a subtle look, you might prefer Milani over the other ones. But honestly, I'm happy with all three of them. I could pick up any one and get really good results. The only difference is these obviously come with more product because these are full-size brow products compared to the Urban Decay that has half pencil and half brow pen. So this is something that I've actually mentioned on my channel before, but it's something I wanted to repeat just in case you guys missed it. My favorite brow gel for a while was the Hourglass Arch Brow Volumizing Fiber Gel, and I wear the shade Dark Brunette. So I did use this up recently. I've just kind of hung on to this because I wanted to feature it in a dupes video. This is pretty expensive. It's $28. It comes in six shades and it comes with 0.10 fluid ounces. Now, I tried the e.l.f. Wow Brow Volumizing Fiber Gel on a whim. I just picked it up randomly on their website, and I actually think that product is better than the Hourglass Brow Gel. Now, that one is $4. This one comes in four different shades, and it actually comes with a little bit more product, 0.12 fluid ounces. Not only is the e.l.f. Brow Gel seven times less expensive than Hourglass, I actually like the wand better. The formulas are so, so similar. I would say the Hourglass formula is maybe a little bit more dry than e.l.f., so it's not quite as wet on the brows, so it dries down a little bit faster, but it also dries out a lot faster when you're actually using the product. That's really the only difference. They both have fibers in them. They define your brows, they lock them into place, and make them look a little bit more thick and voluminous. But the reason why I like the e.l.f. one better is because the wand is smaller. I have really thin, sparse brows. The brows that you're looking at on camera are pretty much all drawn on. I just don't have a lot of brow hair, so I probably should use a serum on my brows to see if it can help. But when I use the wand on the Hourglass product, I end up making a mess. It gets all over the place, and I can definitely be a lot more precise with the e.l.f. brow gel. So if you've been thinking about trying this, or you like it, or you're just looking for a good fiber brow gel, check out e.l.f.'s. It's $4. It works so well. And I'm telling you, it is a dupe for this one. And the wand is better. It's smaller. It's a lot more precise. And I don't know that I'll ever find anything to replace it because I like it so much. I do have some lip products to talk about. So the first one is a color dupe. It's not a formula dupe. And if you're looking for a formula dupe, I'll share one that I do have in just a second, but you guys might know that I do love the Fenty Gloss Bomb in the shade Hot Chocolate. It is my number one lip gloss. I'm wearing it today, and if I had to get rid of every single lip gloss in my collection and just keep one, I would choose this one hands down. I just love the Fenty Gloss Bomb formula as a whole, and if you're looking for a dupe for the formula that has a pretty good shade range, I would recommend checking out the Milani Keep It Full Nourishing Lip Plumpers. I find those to look and feel so similar on the lips, but I don't have an exact color match in that line. So I was going through my collection and I realized this one from ColourPop looks the exact same on the lips. This is their Luxe Gloss in the shade Health Kick. Now the ColourPop Luxe Gloss formula is different, so I'm not saying that you need to run out and buy this one if you're looking for an identical dupe to Fenty's Hot Chocolate, but depending on what type of formula you like, you might prefer this one. The reason why I like the ColourPop Luxe Glosses is because they're kind of like this lip balm lip gloss hybrid. They're very moisturizing, they feel really good on the lips, but they're not overly slippery or overly glossy like the Fenty Gloss Bombs. If you want more of like a balmy, nourishing formula, you might enjoy the Luxe Glosses. But again, if you're just looking for a cheaper alternative in a similar color, I think this one is a great option. Now, I did want to mention the ColourPop Luxe Gloss is $8. The full-size Fenty Hot Chocolate is $19. But they come with a similar amount of products. So you would have to purchase two of the ColourPop glosses to get the same amount as the full-size Fenty gloss. So that's just something to know in case you do go through lip gloss quickly. I'm not someone who really finishes up lip gloss, so I don't mind getting a smaller amount for a less expensive price point, but I did want to mention the value. Another one of my favorite lip gloss formulas is definitely Buxom. I love the Buxom lip polishes. I actually don't have a lot of full-sized Buxom glosses in my collection because I typically purchase the mini sets, but the full-size glosses retail for $21. As soon as I tried the e.l.f. Mint Melt Lip Plumping Glosses, I immediately thought of Buxom. These actually feel like high-end glosses. Again, if you were to put these in high-end packaging, I wouldn't question it. There are some e.l.f. products that really do perform like high-end products. There are some e.l.f. products that don't work for me, but some of them are just really, really good. These retail for $4. They are so glossy and smooth on the lips, and they also have like that mint tingly feel to them. If you like the plumping effect that you typically get with the Buxom lip glosses, try these from e.l.f. These are not an identical dupe, but they're very, very close. When I wear these, like I test them out side by side on half of my lips, and I really couldn't tell a difference. They feel the same, they look the same, they have the same longevity. They're not extremely long-lasting lip glosses. They're not sticky, but they do have like a slight tackiness to them. The Buxom glosses definitely have more of that. So again, I actually prefer the e.l.f. glosses. Now the difference is the e.l.f. glosses only come in like four shades. I would say the e.l.f. lip lacquers from their normal line are kind of similar, but they don't have that plumping effect. So the ones from the Mint Melt line really are my favorite. I think they look so pretty on the lips. And again, if you don't want to spend $21 on a Buxom gloss, try these from e.l.f. For some reason, I have a feeling that this next one might be a well-known dupe. It's not something I've really seen in a YouTube video, but I'm sure it was kind of like floating around on YouTube years ago, but I just discovered this dupe for the first time. So it's new to me, even though it might not be brand new. The Urban Decay Primer Potion is still my go-to eyeshadow primer. After all these years, this is a product that I repurchase over and over. I don't have to repurchase it super often because it does last a very long time, but it's still expensive. It's over $20. It actually retails for $24. So not too long ago, I tried the Milani Eyeshadow Primer, and this one works the exact same. The formulas are identical. This one is a lot less expensive. It's $6.99, and they do come with a similar amount of product. Urban Decay is 0.33 fluid ounces, Milani is 0.3 fluid ounces, but Milani's is $7. So if you're late to the game like me and you haven't tried the Milani eyeshadow primer, definitely try it out. I know that a lot of people do like this one. I just didn't make the connection that it was so similar to Urban Decay's eyeshadow primer potion. It really does the exact same thing. They are both incredibly lightweight, so they're not going to feel heavy on the eyes, but they do prime your eyes for eyeshadow and they lock your eyeshadow into place all day long. So if you haven't tried Milani's yet, I don't think you'll be disappointed. I recently tried the Rare Beauty Melting Blush in the shade Nearly Neutral, and unfortunately it was a big fail for me. I know that some people like this product and I wanted to like it. It just didn't last well on my oily skin. It faded so quickly and I had to reapply this product really within just like 20 minutes of applying it the first time. So I wanted to share two different drugstore cream blush alternatives that I actually think perform better than this one if this one didn't work for you either. The first one is from Milani. I think that I actually like this better because this one has a little bit more of a glowy aspect to it. This one is their, I can never find the name. Oh, Cheek Kiss Cream Blush in the shade You're a Peach. So I like this product because it kind of has like that oily texture to it. So you can go in with your fingers or a sponge or a brush. And this one seems to last a little bit better on my oily skin. They both dry down to more of like a soft matte finish, but this one still keeps some of its glow, which is what I love about cream blushes. The other formula that I think is so similar is the e.l.f. Putty Blush. Now, when you're initially applying this one feels a little bit more dry as you're applying it, but it does build up well and it stays in place a lot better than the Rare Beauty blush. The Rare Beauty blush and the e.l.f. blush dry down, so once they're dry, they kind of have like that cream to powder finish, whereas the Milani blush still stays like a little bit glowy. So this one is not a dupe, it's just an alternative, but I do think the e.l.f. putty blushes are pretty spot on dupes. Now the difference in value is really crazy when it comes to this product. So the Rare Beauty product is $21. It comes with 0.17 ounces, so not a ton of product. The Milani blush is $8.99 and this one comes with 0.37 ounces. So you actually get twice the amount of product for less than half the price. And again, I think that these look so pretty and glowy on the skin. So out of the three, this is probably my favorite formula. Now the e.l.f. putty blushes come with 0.35 ounces, so again, twice as much as you get in Rare Beauty, and Rare Beauty is a little bit less than three times the price of e.l.f. And again, I think e.l.f. just stays in place better, and they do have more shades to choose from than Rare Beauty. Rare Beauty does have a really beautiful shade range, and I love the packaging. I think it's adorable, but the actual product just doesn't perform well for me, so I do recommend Milani or e.l.f. over this one. The last product I want to share with you guys is actually a skincare dupe. Now, skincare dupes are a little bit more difficult because I think you really have to analyze whether or not the ingredients are better. And I was taking a look at the ingredients for this one and it has some really, really good ingredients in it. So it does come down to personal preference, but I feel like when it comes to a cleanser or a cleansing balm, you can kind of get away with, you know, finding a replacement even if the ingredients are not the exact same. So I do like the Drunk Elephant Slay Makeup Melting Cleansing Balm. It's something that I've repurchased. I don't have it in my current collection because I actually have a drugstore alternative, but I do think it performs well, and I will say you do get a lot of product for the price, especially for a Drunk Elephant product. So the Drunk Elephant Cleansing Balm is $34. It comes with 3.88 ounces, so it's actually $8.76 per ounce. So I compared that to a couple of other cleansing balms on the market, and it actually is significantly less expensive than some other alternatives. But this one's even better. This one is the e.l.f. Holy Hydration Makeup Melting Cleansing Balm. First of all, the textures are very, very similar, but I like this one better. It's a lot softer. It's very, very gentle on the skin. The Drunk Elephant one is gentle too, but because this one is so lightweight and smooth, I feel like it just glides over your skin. It removes all of your makeup, all of your eye makeup without irritating the eyes at all. So this one is $10. It comes with 2 ounces, so there is less product, but it's actually $5 per ounce. So it is less expensive price per ounce, and that's something I do take into consideration when it comes to a makeup remover because it's something that I'm going to repurchase over and over. But I will say I actually use less product when it comes to the e.l.f. one rather than Drunk Elephant because this one is so silky and smooth. I feel like it spreads better and it removes your makeup with less product. So I really like this. I think it is a great option. It works extremely well. It's so gentle. It doesn't irritate my eyes. And again, it's $10. So it's definitely worth checking out if you like cleansing balms. Okay guys, that is the end of my video. I think I talked a lot in this video. I just wanted to share all that I could about these products because I was so excited to find them. I love when I can find drugstore and affordable products that perform just as great as high-end alternatives. There are so many drugstore products out there, and a lot of them are really good, but sometimes they just don't work as well. So whenever I can find products that are amazing quality, I just get so excited to share them because I feel like the drugstore as a whole is still kind of underrated. There are so many amazing products for affordable prices. You don't have to spend a ton of money to get great makeup. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I would love to know if you guys know of any drugstore dupes or alternatives that I didn't mention. Please let me know in the comment section below, but I'll see you guys very soon with a new video. Bye.